cooperate. Mathura CG, you have got nine minutes total for your party.
Thank you, sir. At the very outset, I would like to clarify that neither my party nor I am opposed to grant of facilities to people living in worst slums on earth. Well, this is nevertheless, while we support grant of these facilities, that by itself can't be the end, because there has to be organized approach to providing houses for everybody. It is a matter of fact, which is undisputable, that Indian cities are virtually turning into slums. And worse is that their boundaries are increasing every passing day. We are witnessing urbanization, and the other name of urbanization is migration. Migration from small towns to big metros. And shelters, slums are the only shelters that they can get when they come in search of some employment. People migrate from smaller towns, are only laborers, daily wages, sweepers, and they, when they find no other place to be able to live or afford, all that they can do is live in these slums. According to the United Nations Habitat and World Bank report, 90% of the urban growth which has taken place is in the developing nations. Asia and Africa constitute over 80% of this. But this urbanization is that of poverty. It leads to growth of slums, and instead of building proper housing colonies for them, we simply say that let them stay where they are, which are unhygienic. But yet, there will be an ordinance, and there will be an extension of the ordinance, and there will not be any proper examination of the problem and find a lasting solution where the poorest of poor who come to serve and earn their account of living will also be given a respectable housing in the dwellers in slums and in unauthorized colonies cannot be treated merely as vote banks. They are humans, and they have a right under Article 21 of the Constitution to be able to lead a life of dignity. The slum dynamics of Delhi, particularly Delhi, is slow rate of urban growth but high percentage of slum population. That's the manner in which most of the large cities in India are destined. I cannot I want to say that the ad hoc arrangement merely is an eyewash and amounts to evading the problem. More than 30% of the population of Delhi, that is 40 lakh people, live in slums or in unauthorized colonies. Is there going to be an effort to find a lasting solution to this? Are they going to be given a life of dignity or not? One third of this population, of Delhi's population, is living in miserable conditions. There are no dispensaries, no schools, no proper roads, and no proper houses. By merely regularizing them time and again in a repetitive fashion, the government must have a far-sighted approach and find a solution to this. Living conditions in these places are horrible. 30% of the population and 50% of the dwellers are suffering from ailments, one ailment or the other. Slums have garbage piled up on the streets. Inadequate lighting, 51% of the children of Delhi slums have stunted growth. Health hazards or urban slum dwellers directly related to poverty are more prone to communicable diseases and malnutrition. There is greater risk of accidents at work because of the manner in which they spend their life in these hell holes. From the United Nations to every city planner in developing countries, the primary target is city without slums. If that is the target which the government will adopt, perhaps we can have a beginning of a solution. The present government claims to have been very keen to develop some of the cities with vibrant infrastructure facilities to allure international investment with the so-called smart cities. But how many smart cities have we seen since 2014? We seem to have them only on paper and for publication in the advertisements. Union government promised 100 smart cities in 5 years. Till October 2019, only 30% of the funds were released. We can't simply do jumlas and expect any change. Out of 3,700 projects worth 1,36,000 crore, only 959 projects worth 15,260 crores are reported to have been completed. The ambitious Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, launched by the Honorable Prime Minister, promised 1.2 crore houses till by 2022. Till 22nd March of 2018, only 10% of the projected number of houses were complete. Parliamentary Oversight Committee stated that out of the central share of 57,699 crore, only 26,162 crore, that means about half of the amount, have been sanctioned for release by the Union government. Committee was constrained to note that all is not well with the implementation of the scheme and that the progress of PMAY has been disappointing. The report also noted that Smart City Mission and Atal Mission for rejuvenation of urban transformation, the government will spend the money, but they have failed to execute the projects even though 3 years have passed since the schemes were launched on 25th February 2015. All that I would say is that if the priorities were right, instead of spending 20,000 crore on Central Vista, the government could have built housing colonies and provided those 1 crore houses within this month.
Thank you. Courteous Tulsi Sahab. Dr. Anil Agrawal Ji, sirf 7 minutes.